Hello boaters, welcome to Narrowboat Journeys. My name is Phil, and I've lived aboard my narrowboat on the canal system for over 30 years. I share my home with my two cats, Bushka and Midge, and we spend our days travelling around the canal system and making videos. I'm on the North Oxford Canal, and just leaving the village of Ansty, and in this video we'll be travelling as far as Brinklow. So I think before we go any farther, let's have a look at the map. We're starting at the yellow marker up at the top of the map and finishing at the other yellow marker down near the bottom right. It's a very rural trip, mostly through open countryside, although we are close to the railway line quite a lot of the time. On the way we'll pass a water point and a swing bridge. Up ahead there's a bit of towpath restoration and some dredging going on, so I'll need to pass by these boats carefully. Over on the right is a section of towpath that they've completed. The North Oxford Canal consists of lots of long straight sections, and the towpath looks quite inviting there, but you try mooring up because they use a lot of diagonally sloping stones to edge the canal, and it's very difficult to moor up against. That was the first of many trains I encountered on this trip. I think this swan is racing me. This narrow bit is the beginning of a long embankment. This narrow bit marks the end of the embankment, depending on which way you're travelling, of course. Up ahead is another motorway, that's the M6. There are quite a few water voles on this canal. If you look closely, you can often see them swimming in the water. There's one just up ahead, look. If you're observant, you'll often see them on the bank side as well. We now come to a very long stretch of moored boats. You do need to be quite careful up here if it's windy, because this is a very exposed location and the prevailing wind is likely to blow you towards those boats, so Be careful, no problems today, of course. It's nice and calm. Eventually we get to the end of the moored boats, and the boats over on the right there, that's the towpath side. Well, I was thinking of stopping here, but I changed my mind because there was a big dog on the towpath and I thought that's probably not a good idea with the cats, so I decided to carry on. I don't think I'd like to have a mooring along here. Far too noisy with those trains. However, we're just approaching Rose Narrowboat, as a boatyard just up ahead. As you can see, there's a small swing bridge blocking the canal just up ahead. It's easy to operate. Over to the right, I believe there's a CRT rubbish disposal point. Not 100% sure. And on the left, we've got a canal arm, which is used mainly for mooring, so you can't really go down there. There are some visitor moorings just on the other side of that bridge. They're not in very good condition though, the bank was quite bad. On the right is the remains of another canal arm. This one used to go to the village of Brinklow itself, but it's very, very short now. It's just cut off immediately under that bridge. Walking along the road to the right will take you to the village of Brinklow. This is probably the best way to access the village. You notice up ahead you can see some boats. That's a very popular mooring spot up there. So this bridge is your nearest to the village of Brinklow. There's a post office there, a couple of pubs. The post office is also a convenience store as well. Very small, but you can get a few things in there. These moorings up ahead do get very busy at certain times of the year, so I'm going to stop a little bit short of them. Anyway, I think that's the end of my trip for this one, so thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next time.